Thanks to Brilliant for sponsoring this video.
We are 1 month away from Christmas Day, and I wanted to set myself a challenge. For as many people as possible watching this video right now, could I predict if you are going to see a white Christmas this year? Make sure you stick around till the end of the video because I will be giving percentage probabilities that you, as many of you as possible, will see a white Christmas. First of all, I identified the countries where most of my viewers come from. So looking at my YouTube analytics, over the past year, most of my audience has come from, in descending order, the USA, the UK, India, Canada, Germany, Australia, the Netherlands, the Philippines, Sweden, and Brazil. I then looked up the most popular city in each one of those countries. So the idea is we're going to pick one point in each of the countries that are best representative of my audience to try and catch as many people as possible. From 1948 to the present day, I then looked up in which years these cities saw white Christmases, which is actually more difficult than you'd think, partly because different people classify a white Christmas in a different way. Like in Germany, a white Christmas is a Christmas where there's snow on the ground on Christmas Eve, Christmas Day, and Boxing Day. While here in the UK, if we see a single flake of snow in the sky on Christmas Day, that's it, that's a white Christmas.
It's snowing!
Also, I cannot stress enough how frustrating it is that Irving Berlin wrote a song called White Christmas when all I want is white Christmas data about Berlin, Germany. Note that I did try and standardize this as best I could, so for this experiment, a white Christmas is if, on the 25th of December, there is snow in the air or on the ground. With all of the data compiled, I then put it into a spreadsheet, and, well, I hate to say it, but if you live in Sao Paulo, Quezon City, Mumbai, or Sydney, I don't think you're going to get a white Christmas this year. Mostly because it's summer. Or you live in the tropics. For the six remaining cities then, we can actually use this data to get an estimate of the chance of a white Christmas right off the bat by taking a frequentist approach. This basically means counting up the number of years we have data for and then counting up the number of years in which we see a white Christmas. You divide one number by the other and you get a percentage chance that any given year will contain a white Christmas. Unfortunately, this isn't a particularly useful estimate because it basically assumes that every year is exactly like every other year. We can definitely do better. So how would you normally predict the weather? Well, normally you would take observations of the state of the atmosphere and the ocean and the land temperature right now, and then feed them into the equations that govern how the atmosphere and the land behave. So these are informed by physics and then get put into the form of a computer simulation. You then track that simulation forwards into the future until you reach whatever target date you have in mind, for us, December 25th, and you see what the results are, what the conditions predicted by the model are. Unfortunately, we can't really do that here, because a month is a really long time in weather. The equations that describe how the atmosphere behaves are chaotic, which means that while the present describes the future, the approximate present doesn't describe the approximate future. Basically, because we don't have thermometers and barometers on every square centimeter of land, and there are small error bars on every measurement, the fields that we put into our computer simulations have a small error associated with them, and that error only gets bigger and bigger as you go further and further into the future of your simulation. By the time you reach a week, maybe 2 weeks into the future, your prediction will have absolutely nothing to do with what reality turns out to be. Your errors are just unacceptably large. So we can't use numerical weather prediction, like a powerful computer model, to predict a white Christmas this year. But there is another option. The weather that takes place on a given day is going to be somewhat informed by the weather that took place in the recent past. So the chance that you see snow on a particular day is probably going to have something to do with the temperature that place saw in, say, the past month, or the amount of precipitation, how much rain or snow already fell on that location in the previous month. Taking that idea, what if we look back through the data and looked at which years saw white Christmases for given cities, and then for those cities saw how warm were they in November, how much rain did they see in November? Could we use that information to get a better prediction, maybe, of the chance of seeing snow on December 25th? This is what's called a logistic regression, where we're taking a continuous field like temperature or precipitation and using that to predict a binary outcome. So white Christmas or no white Christmas. To accomplish this, I downloaded the data from the nearest World Meteorological Organization weather station to each of the six cities, looking at the monthly average temperature and monthly average precipitation for November. There was actually a lot of code in this bit. When they didn't all start in the same year, and there were some years missing. And basically, we ended up with a data set, all right? I don't want to talk about it. I did this for every year that we had white Christmas data for each city, and then built a data set where we had all the years where we had snow data, and temperature data, and precipitation data.
Did this work?
Absolutely not. When calculating the correlation between the temperature and the precipitation and there being a white Christmas or not, the confidence was just so low, meaning that there was basically very little statistical influence of the weather in November and there being snow or not on the 25th of December. Unfortunately, it's still a chaotic system. The weather over the current month of November isn't really going to have that much of an influence on the weather at the end of December. So how do we beat chaos?
Can't you beat chaos?
No. We look at the big picture. The atmosphere is a horrifically complicated set of interacting fields like wind and temperature and humidity and pressure, and it's all too much for any human to keep in their head at once. So scientists invented some fancy statistical tricks like principal component analysis to basically draw out the basic story of what the atmosphere is doing at any given time. For example, in the northern hemisphere, which is where all of our cities are, the air pressure is best described using something called the Arctic Oscillation, which is basically a measure of how wiggly the jet stream is, and so how likely it is that you're going to see extremely cold air spill out from the Arctic into mid-latitudes. The Arctic Oscillation has a pattern associated with it, which tells us that it's about the strength of the jet stream, basically, and then a number associated with it, its index. That index basically says, is the jet stream anomalously strong and stable, or is it anomalously weak and wobbly? So if you were to try and describe what the atmosphere in the northern hemisphere is doing at any one time, at least at the surface, then your best bet would be the Arctic Oscillation Index, the one number that sums up the most possible variability in the northern hemisphere. If, however, you were more interested in oceans rather than atmospheres, then the principal component of sea surface temperatures is the El Niño Southern Oscillation, which is basically like a tongue of warm water that goes across the Pacific. It's complicated. And you can represent the strength of ENSO with another index. I'm using Niño 3.4 for all of you statistics nerds out there. And the wonderful thing about these indices is that they vary on much longer timescales than atmospheric variables at a particular location. So in London, for example, the temperature might vary significantly day to day or even within a day, whilst the Arctic Oscillation Index varies smoothly over weeks and months. And that means that with enough data, you can predict what it will be quite a few weeks into the future, further than you could predict the weather. And this is where it gets really great, because we are at a point where we can predict what the El Niño index will be, or what the Arctic Oscillation index will be in December. We have enough information. And that means you can look through past years at the relationship between the AO index and the ENSO index and the chance of a place receiving a white Christmas or not, both within the month of December. So you can get a much stronger statistical relationship. Informed by the logic that all of our cities are in the northern hemisphere breathing air and most of them are on the coast, I downloaded the data for the El Niño index and the AO index in December of all the previous years in which I had snowfall data and did the same analysis. The logistic regression. And the statistical relationships are much, much stronger. We're talking some p-values here of less than 0.01. Like, ooh. Of course, that shows why we use these indices. They capture a lot of the variability of the atmosphere of the ocean in a single number. That's literally what we invented them to do. And for each one of the cities, the value of the Arctic Oscillation Index correlated really well with the probability that the city received a white Christmas. Although there were a couple of cities actually where the El Niño correlation was stronger, statistically stronger, which means I can make predictions of the chance of a white Christmas this year with a reasonable amount of confidence in my predictions. And without further ado, let's go to the weather.
Starting off with Stockholm. If you live in the capital of Sweden, I predict this year there's a 51% chance you will see a white Christmas. Now, 54% of previous years saw white Christmases. The lower probability this year is because of the really strong influence that the Arctic Oscillation seems to have on the probability, and the AO is in a neutral phase this December. It's a similar story in Amsterdam, another city very strongly affected by the Arctic Oscillation, but in this case it doesn't actually change the probability very much. 7% of past Christmases were white. I predict this year there's about a 7% chance of seeing white Christmas. It's a different story in Berlin, however. 29% of previous years saw a white Christmas. I predict this year there's only a 20% chance. Again, that's because of a very strong statistical relationship between the AO index and the probability of a white Christmas. In Toronto, the ocean is in charge with a strong relationship between the El Niño index and the probability of a white Christmas. 36% of past Christmases in Toronto were white. This year, with December seeing a negative El Niño index, about minus 1.5, I predict there to be a 55% chance of a white Christmas. Next, the one I'm personally invested in, London. 11% of past years have seen white Christmases. This year, I reckon about an 18% chance of a white Christmas. And this is an interesting one because it's a mix of El Nino influence and Arctic Oscillation influence. So not exactly a high chance, but slightly higher than normal. And lastly, in New York, the strong influence of the Arctic Oscillation coming in again, I predict a 12% chance of a white Christmas. Compare that to 14% of past Christmases being white, slightly less chance than normal. Sorry, New Yorkers. Oh, and in the interest of completeness, Mumbai, Sydney, Quezon City, Sao Paulo, it's 0%. Sorry again. This has only been one example of probability. People who follow the world of sport or people who play tabletop games will know that probability governs so much of what we experience. Don't even get me started on quantum mechanics. But how much do you really know about how probability works? For example, suppose you flip a fair coin 10 times. What's the probability of the last two flips being heads if you know that the first 8 flips were heads? This is a problem from the Applied Probability course on Brilliant, a website that encourages learners of all ages to get stuck in with concepts by solving problems. Their probability course covers the basics right the way up to Markov chains and recursion, and is only one of dozens of expertly written, beautifully illustrated, interactive courses on topics in science and maths and computer science. It's a website and app perfect for those few minutes you have spare in the mornings. Rather than mindlessly scroll through Instagram, why not get a little bit smarter every day and solve some problems? If you fancy supporting the learning of a student in your life, and also this channel, and seeing as this is a Christmas video, you can get a premium subscription to Brilliant as a gift for yourself or others, giving access to all the courses, daily challenges, and practice material. Go to brilliant.org/Simon Clark, and the first 200 people to do so will get 20% off. Thanks again to Brilliant for sponsoring this video.
Thank you so much for watching the video. I hope you enjoyed it, and if you are celebrating Christmas this year, I hope you have a happy one and a safe one. Wash your hands. Over the past year or so, I have been working on a huge background project I'm still actually not allowed to tell you about, but basically, the hard part of it is now over and I can get back to making more videos for your viewing pleasure. So I am sorry that there haven't been as many videos as I would like to have made over the past couple of months, but in the new year, I've got some really bizarre ideas that are pent up and I cannot wait to make them. Thank you again for watching. If you enjoyed it, you know what to do. You can give it a like, you can let me know your feedback in the comments, and you could even share it. That's the one that really helps, actually. Thank you again, and I'll see you in the next one. And Merry Christmas? It just feels wrong saying it in November.